Get ready to match the stars. Scoey Mitchell, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Patty Duke Aston, Richard Dawson, and Patty Deutsch as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Ryder.
Friend. You're very kind to come in and help us out and scream and holler and laugh and applaud and do all of those things. We're very grateful to you, and we thank you for joining us. Are you all quite ready up here?
Oh, golly, yes.
Anything, does anyone have anything on his or her mind?
Yes, but I can't say it on CBS.
No, you can, then. Are you
not
ready?
Not a thing. It's yes. Completely empty.
Well, then let's get right to it. Shall we do that and say hello to our two players, Monica Goetz and John Schlicker?
I do.
Okay, Monica's the current champion. You're piling up quite a bit of money there, $5,700, Monica. What are you going to do with all that loot?
Spend it.
Okay. Monica is a lady wrestler. Her professional name is...
Lola Kiss.
Lola Kiss, the kiss of death. But she's been very nice to most of us so far here. She's being challenged by John Schlicker here. He's had his first round question. We finished round one altogether. Right. And we're going to start with you with round two in a moment or so. But right now, we got to do a little business, America. Pay attention. All right, here we go. Gee, they've painted the set. Look at this.
We have new microphones.
And new microphones?
No, Akron had a sale.
Does this mean we're going to stay on? Is that what it is? All right, I'll push the button here with my magic finger and ask John to make his selection.
I'll try A.
A. All right, everybody plays. Everybody except Patty.
Which one?
Oh, and I rushed for nothing. Oh, it's
could have done this round anyhow.
Yes, we've never had two patties before. You do not write.
Yeah, I know. I said I rushed for nothing.
Yes. Listen to this, folks. You never see any flies flying around Colonel Sanders' chicken store because when a fly flies into the Colonel's kitchen, the Colonel blanks it. That's what happens in the Colonel's kitchen. When a fly flies in there, the Colonel blanks it. This is Colonel Sanders. You know the one with the beard and the white hair and all that?
And the funny hat.
Yeah, and the funny hat.
And the chicken wings.
And the chicken wings,
all that
sure.
Stuff. Right. I got it.
Okay. All right, everybody ready down here?
Oh, I got it.
No flies in the Colonel's chicken store, Charles. You remember me, don't you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Charles, you have the cutest dimples.
Thank you.
He
eat
does.
Your heart out, Cary Grant.
I don't want to say any more because it's very distracting to him if I direct any direct conversation
okay,
at him.
Let's
he
go.
Has a very tenuous mind, you see. Now we are ready. Just put it in the slot, Charles. Okay, John. You never see any flies flying around Colonel Sanders' chicken store because when a fly flies into the Colonel's kitchen, the Colonel blanks it.
He cooks them.
He cooks the fly. Now, why are you booing? That's not a bad answer.
That's a terrific answer.
Who's the weirdo who booed? Stand up. All right, everybody, jump on him then. Now, that's not a bad answer at all. Now, Scoey, he says he cooks them.
I think that was a good answer.
Right. What'd you say?
I said he cooks them.
There, you see. Brett, what'd you say?
Well, I do believe this is a match. He deep fries it and puts it in a bucket.
All deep right. Fries it and puts it in a bucket? Okay. So that's three for you, John. Charles?
I just said he buckets it.
He buckets it.
You can get 320,004 flies into a bucket or only 308,000 if they're the horse.
Just puts them in a bucket, eh? No cooked flies there. All
I
right.
I said he had fried flies.
Fries, it, cooks it. That's four for you, John. Right. All right. Now, Richard, it's up to you.
Why, sir, I couldn't let the gentleman down.
Well, there it is. Cook five for you. If you don't match five and end up in a tie, you know, or If you match less than that, why, he is going to be the winner. But since you are a wrestler, you wouldn't do him any physical violence, would you? I mean, you could throw him off the stage if you wanted to, though, couldn't you?
Oh, if I want to.
If you want to, yes. But he's a nice fellow. You wouldn't do that to him. Okay, everybody plays. Dumb Dora is so dumb. I'll tell you how dumb he is. Just shut up and wait for me. When her husband started to grow a beard, Dumb Dora wanted it to grow faster, so she blanked it. That's how dumb Dumb Dora was. When her husband wanted to start to grow a beard, she wanted it to grow faster, so she blanked.
There were several terrific, so dumb.
Yeah, that's good. That's very good. All right, that's fine. Everybody's got a good idea here.
Oh, Scully, I don't know what's wrong with that little darling person.
I would love to live inside her mind for a week.
Yeah, 1 week. Wouldn't that be something? Monica, Dumb Dora is so dumb. Ask me how dumb she is.
How dumb she is.
Okay, it's all right. No, I tell you how dumb she is. When her husband started to grow a beard, Dumb Dora wanted it to grow faster, so she blanked it.
Pulled it.
She pulled it. I don't know if that'd make it grow faster. You got to match five to stay in the game. Scoy, what'd you say?
I don't know, but it wasn't as bad as what she said.
Well, we'll be the judge of that.
I imagine this is a little cultural throwback. She put a stocking cap on it. Used to make my hair grow faster.
Yeah, that's why they call you fuzzy now, eh? Okay, what do you say? He said she put a stocking cap on it.
Is she going to give me a half Nelson in the parking lot?
No.
You sure?
No, she's very
sweet. Because I said watered, I'm sorry.
She watered it, yeah. So now, what's the rest of you have? Congratulations.
Thank you.
You stand by for a moment or so here while we say goodbye to Lola Kiss, lady wrestler.
Much.
Did you have a good time, Lola?
I had a wonderful time. Thank
That's
you.
Good. And you got $5,700 in addition to that. Monica Getz. Goodbye, my dear. While she's spinning off, we're going to spin a little message for you, and then you hurry right back and see how he does with the big money here. Here's old John Schlicker. Ready, John?
I'm ready.
Okay. He's going to try for over $5,000 here now, and we'll get right to it, John. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Trial blank. Now, the answer that audience gave most frequently is worth $500 to you if you match it. If you match the answer they gave second most frequently, you get $250, and the third most frequently given response nets you $100. Three of our celebrities are permitted to help. Whom do you call on?
I'll try Richard.
Trial by jury.
Trial by jury is one.
And Brett.
Brett.
What about trial and error?
Trial and error.
And Charles.
What do you say, Charles?
Trial by
panic. In third position is difficult.
Oh, it really is.
Are all your votes in? Miss Deutsch with Trial and Tribulation.
Trial and Tribulation.
There were some good ones here, but that's the one I'm going
yes.
with.
All right. Trial and Tribulation, Trial by Jury, and Trial and Error are the three that have been suggested. Have you got a better one, or do you want to go with one of those?
I'll go with Brett, Trial and Error.
Trial and Error is the one? You let the audience influence you, didn't you?
Yes.
All right, audience. He said his decision was influenced by your enthusiastic applause for Trial and Error. And if it doesn't come out Trial and Error in the $500 spots, Lola Kiss, the lady wrestler, is going to walk among you and break your arms. Let's begin down at the bottom here and reveal, if you would please, Earl, the $100 response. Trial by jury. That's the one that Richard gave you. Okay. We're still looking for trial and error. Let's see if it's out of the $250 response. Trial and error it is. Congratulations, John. You got it there, pal. There it is. Now. How is it with a mustache?
Nice. That's very good. Pleasant indeed.
Okay. Well, I think I'll try it. What do you think is under the big one there? Trial what? Oh, trial and oh, let's see it. Slide it, Earl. That's very interesting. All this bunch down here were hollering trial of Billy Jack. My. And it hadn't occurred to me.
Elton John fan club. They know all about that. Yeah.
Are you the Elton John fan club?
Yeah, they love him.
Why don't you write to him and ask him if he'd like to be one of our celebrities sometime? Would you do that? All right. If you're in his fan club, tell him to do that. And all right. Now, you got $250. You're going to play for 10 times that amount or $2,500. To collect that, you've got to match one of our celebrities exactly head-to-head.
Richard.
Okay, you face me, John. Richard will write his response to this. Here we go. Blank tent. T-E-N-T.
Blank tent.
Or blank tent. Now, he's finished. John, what answer do you want to suggest that you think will match his?
Pup tent.
Pup tent. Right out with it. Bing,
it's
his pup tent. That'll match you for $2,500.
What does it mean? What's a pup tent?
Pup tent. It's a tent where pups sleep. A pup tent is a one-man tent used in the army.
Pup!
$2,850. Who's down there?
Suzanne.
Yeah, where is she? Right in the middle. Oh, there she is. Yeah, you remember her. Yeah, I do indeed. She was on our show, wasn't she?
And Kay.
Yeah?
She was on the show,
too. Right. Okay. Well, I'm glad they recruited you. Now, if you're ready to carry on, John, you got $2,850. You're going to meet another challenger here right now. Let's welcome Pat Wiley. Hi, Pat. All right. Okay, John. Pat, you know John Schlicker. Are you ready to tell us a little bit about Pat Wiley?
Yes, I'm a secretary. I've got two sons, Patrick and Keith. They've got two dogs, Charlie and Amigo. All four of them are at home rooting for me and driving my mother up the wall. And my good luck charm came with me. He's in the audience. And my beautiful cousin came with me.
Your husband and your cousin are here.
My good luck charm.
Oh, I beg your pardon. Oh, I see. All right. Any way you want to play it, Pat, is what do I care? Yes, her husband's. Okay. Oh, dear me. Ah. All right. Now, Pat, would you please make a selection here?
I'll take B.
B it is, here.
Expression, good luck to you, young man.
Lots of luck. Barney said I've got good news and bad news. The bad news is California just fell into the ocean. The good news is so did blank. I think this is a winner. Yes, it's a marvelous question.
But we could get in so much trouble.
The good news is California just fell into the ocean. Now, wait a minute. The bad news is California just fell into the ocean. The good news is so did blank.
Oh, kiss me, you fool.
All right, so I know you love me, but just stay up there now because... You finished.
I finished. Would you like to see my answer?
Yes, let me just have a little peek out. The bad news is California just
fell into the ocean.
The San Andreas Fault went bing like that.
Yeah.
And the whole state slid right into the ocean, you see?
Yeah.
That's the bad news.
Right.
Now, the good news is so did blank.
Yeah, thank you.
Well, that explains.
Doesn't that clarify it for you?
Yeah.
Okay, put it in the slot there now. Come on, now you're all creative.
Good gravy, Charles, when you wake up.
That's
See, sometimes you have, if you speak sharply,
that's right.
Snaps his brain
okay.
into shape.
So he's
go over there. Would you give the winning card?
Oh, yes, John, there's the John. This is the one that won him a lot of money. All right, John, there's a little souvenir for you. Everybody ready? Patty, what are you doing? Did you change your mind?
Which one?
I mean, Patty Deutsch. Patty Duke and Patty Deutsch. Now she's ready. So, Pat Wiley. Barney said, and that has nothing to do with the question, it's just an arbitrary, we like to change names. Barney said, I've got good news and bad news. The bad news is California just fell into the ocean. The good news is so did blank.
Florida?
Florida.
Hang in there, sister. Hang in.
That's it. Don't let them discombobulate you, you know, because when you see some of the rotten answers that are going to appear now as we go to our celebrities who took 27 minutes to make up their minds. All right, Scoey, you didn't take too long, did you?
No, it might just be wishful thinking on my part. I said San Clemente.
Oh, I see. Okay. Brett?
I wish to preface my answer with a statement. I don't want any letters. So did Poland.
All right, Charles.
This is the only show where Florida can get booed and San Clemente an ovation. Very strange. I said maybe it's a match. The rest of the USA.
The rest of the USA.
Which is a boring, boring answer.
Yeah. All right. Now,
well, mine's not any better.
Yours not any better? What'd you say?
I chose Chicago, New York, and San Clemente.
Chicago, New York.
All cluttered places.
Yes, all the cluttered
San
places.
San Clemente is part of California, isn't it?
San Clemente is part of California.
That's why I just sort of threw it in on the end.
That would already be in, right?
That would already
be in. Well, it depends on who's living there.
The good news is, so did ex-President Nixon.
Yes!
Still wearing his seal.
Yes, I didn't do anything wrong.
No.
What'd you say, Patty?
I have another political answer.
Yes.
I said Cal Worthington and his damn dog, Spot.
Oh, that's fine. That's right. Oh, yeah, now hold on. The people here in the studio audience are hooting and hollering and all that. So, in fairness to Florida, which is about to slide into the Atlantic Ocean, before they go, you ought to explain to who Cal Worthington.
I can't explain Cal Worthington.
I can. All right, Richard will explain it. Yeah.
Cal Worthington is a brain surgeon. Well, he sells cars.
He's a used car salesman.
Yeah. And he has a hippopotamus, which he calls Spot. Well, I'll show you the state we're in here.
So, Pat, you didn't score at all with your first round question. John, yours will be along in a moment or so, but right now we want to pass along this message. We're ready to carry on. Our second question here in round one. John, this is for you. Listen carefully. Everybody plays. It's Vladimir said. He says, I have proof that CIA is tampering with mail to my embassy. Oh. I will tell you how I have proof. On St. Valentine's Day, I send our ambassador Candygram. You know what is Candygram, right? You know. Shut up. I send our ambassador Candygram and CIA blanked his candy.
As an acting teacher, it was very good, but if the question were just a little longer, which is long enough, you could have possibly gotten the accent. I love you. I can't do it.
Darling, you got just a little Swedish in the middle.
Yes.
No.
No?
Sounded real color to me.
Put an answer down and let's press out.
I've got an answer down. Okay. I've been through for days.
All right. You've got it. Very good, Scoey. Just put an answer. Oh, you got it.
Yeah, what do you?
All right. Now we come to John Schlicker. Vladimir said, he says, I have proof that CIA is tampering with mail to my embassy. On St. Valentine's Day, I send our ambassador Candygram, and CIA blanked his candy.
The CIA bugged it.
They bugged his candy. He say, bugged his candy. So what do you say?
I don't know why he said bugged his candy.
Why?
Well, I just said that they did something stupid like
they ate the candy. All right, Brett.
He didn't.
didn't bug at his candy, honey. He done ate it.
He ate the candy. That's the answer, John. All right, Charles.
I said the same thing,
Senator. He ate the candy.
They were very
hungry.
Duke,
did he ate the candy? He ate the candy. Richard, is he a candy eater?
They swallowed.
He's a swallowed candy. Patty?
I said the CIA jailed it.
They jailed the candy. What do they know? Okay, so at the end of round one, we got a real squeaker going here, haven't we? I don't want to say we got a couple of dummies up here, but that's what it is. No, first round questions are difficult, and we'll go to round two a little later on, but right now we got to go to this. You have 15 seconds to sing the farewell scene from Lucia di Lammermoor.
I'm on the watch.
Ready?
Lucia di Lammermoor.
Cut.
Thank
Sorry.
You.
You'll have to come back another time. Gene Rayburn, Match Game 75. Join us next time. Goodbye.
A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.